You know, I never had that much confidence in women.
Yeah, as liars.
Right. They can't be trusted.
And I agree with that. Ah, they're entitled to the compliment. They deserve to be called the honest sex.
Why shouldn't they be? I mean, they got the rest of us working overtime to steal and cheat for them.
Yeah, they're running wild.
You know, I don't think I ever seen a better scheme than my brother cooked up.
You know, the Russian bride scam?
No. This was the spinoff. The Great Moral and Malevolent Matrimonial Agency. There's money to be made if you got the initial capital.
How much?
You come up with $3,000 and we'll talk. I'm not sure you'd have me divulge into details unless you were a serious investor.
That is serious.
And you can double it in 60 days, which is about as long as you can extend a scheme like ours without applying for a business license.
Yeah, or having plastic surgery, whichever is easier.
Charming widow, beautiful, fun-loving, 32 years, possessing $3,000 cash and owning valuable country property, would remarry. Would consider a poor man with affectionate disposition to one with means, as the solid virtues are often found in the humbler walks of life. No objection to elderly man or one of homely appearance, if faithful and true and competent to manage property and invest money with judgment. Address with particulars, signed, lonely, care of Peters and Tucker Agents, Carroll, Illinois.
I got one this time!
So far, so deceitful.
And now, what about the woman?
Jeff, I thought you'd lost those ideas of realism in your art. Why should there be a lady? You know, if they're selling a bunch of watered stock on Wall Street, would you expect to find a mermaid in it?
Well, I just thought we had a lady.
Okay, just a minute. You know my rules. I have always, even in my legitimate business, required some proof of performance.
Well, I just thought it'd be wise, in case an officer was to come snooping around the shop.
We shall be capable of producing a widow of some fashion. It's agreed and settled.
Well, I've never encountered a problem that a good cigar and a $5 bill couldn't square, but just in case, you know.
And I know just the woman.
An old friend of mine used to work for the circus as a sword swallower. One night he made his wife a widow by drinking some dyspepsia cure instead of his usual liniment by mistake. The widow Trotter fit our ad first rate.
Trotter?
Except for beauty, age, and property valuation.
Is this an honest deal?
Mrs. Trotter, Jeff and I have computed the calculation that nearly 3,000 men in this country will endeavor to secure your fair hand and ostensible money and property through our advertisement. Of that, number, maybe 3,000 or so will give you in exchange, should they win you, the carcass of a lazy and mercenary loafer, a failure in life, a swindler and contemptible fortune seeker. Jeff and I intend to teach these low-life reprobates a lesson. There is, I admit, the slim chance that some of the more ardent suitors will raise the fare to come to see you personally and press their suit, whatever fraction of a suit they may be wearing. In that case, you'll likely be forced to reject them face to face. Pay $25 a week plus hotel expenses?
I'll get my bag.
How's this sound? Dear sir, I was deeply impressed with your interesting and straightforward letter.
Each letter received a response asking them to send a more detailed letter, stating more particulars and enclosing a photograph where convenient. Peters and Tucker Matrimonial Agency also informed the applicant that their fee for handing over the second letter would be $2 enclosed therewith.
You know, this operation does have a sort of simplistic beauty, does it not? Who would have thought that 90% of these would-be noblemen could scrape up $2?
Ow! Really gotta hire somebody to help us open up these envelopes.
Only the hardest cases would come back to us for carfare. And at the height of our merriment, we netted over $200 a day.
I've sort of been expecting you.
I see you've had a rather large mail delivery.
Come on. I'll show you the goods. And how was Mrs. Roosevelt when you left Washington?
Oh. Peters and Tucker Matrimonial Agency was covered. Take the revenueer to see the widow, show him the savings book, and send him home empty-handed.
August 1st, 1910. $3,000 deposit. Good. Well, good luck with your business.
Thanks. Thanks for coming down.
Good day, Mr. Peters.
Say, if you weren't already married, I'd send you back to talk with the lady for a while longer. We won't mention the $2.
Thanks. If I wasn't, I might. Good day, Mr. Tucker.
Good day.
Toward the end of 3 months, we had taken in something over $6,000 and decided it was time to quit. So we decided to pull out, and I head to Mrs. Trotter's hotel to say farewell and pay her last week's salary. And finally, to get her check for $3,000. When I get there, I find her crying like a kid who don't want to go to school.
What's the matter? Did somebody get lippy with you, or are you just getting homesick?
No, Mr. Peters. You knew my husband, so I don't mind telling you this. Mr. Peters, I'm in love. I just love a man so hard, I just can't bear not to have him.
Well, then take him. If it's a mutual case, that is. Does he share the same sentiment for you according to the specifications and painfulness you describe?
He does. But he's one of the men who's been coming to see me about the advertisement. And he won't marry me unless I give him the $3,000. His name is William Wilkinson. And he's a good man. I just know it.
Mrs. Trotter, there's no one more sympathetic to a woman's affections than I am. Besides, you were once the life partner of one of my best friends. If it were up to me, I'd say take the $3,000 and the man of your choice and be happy. Yeah, why not? We made a potful from the hapless bastards who want to marry you. No offense. Of course, I would have to consult with Mr. Tucker.
I was afraid of something like this. You can't trust any woman to stand by you in a scheme involving her emotions.
But, Jeff, it's a sad thing to think that we were the cause of a woman's heartbreak.
Yeah, all right. Perhaps I have been too cynical and suspicious. I'll meet you halfway. You go back to the widow, tell her to draw out the money, and give it to this man that she's so infatuated with.
Oh, Jeff!
So I'm so happy I shake his hand for fairly 5 minutes. and the little trotter is happier than me. Want to go meet the widow Trotter before we leave? I'm sure she'd like to express her gratitude.
Besides, you might catch her bathing.
Nah, I guess not. I guess we better hurry up and catch that train. Here. Better put this with the rest.
What's this?
Mrs. Trotter's 3,000.
What are you doing with it?
Yeah, she gave it to me. I've been calling on her 3 nights a week for the last month.
Then, you are William Wilkinson?
I was.